Good afternoon to all. Tomorrow Options is a technological startup based in Sheffield, South Yorkshire. In fact, we are interested in measuring the movement of humans or from their body parts and going a little bit far of what is called or known the Internet of Things to what we call internally as the Internet of Bodies. Our vision is having one of our devices monitoring any human that fits on the market segments that we address. Because movement and the analysis of movement is the great source of information. We have two devices in the market, one that measures the activity and the position of bedridden patients to help nurses do the repositioning activities to avoid pressure ulcers, and the device that I will present today, that is a device that monitors lower limbs to provide information to be used to take care of lower limbs disorders in healthcare, but also in sports. Nature designed our feet to be flexible, to deal efficiently with the exchange of energy between our body and the ground, but also to adapt well to the different surfaces and to protect about shocks the other parts of the body. But nowadays, all of us are wearing shoes and with hard soles, and basically we are walking on cities where the surfaces are flat and hard. This is a source of enormous problems for our body, and is affecting us every day, and affecting the full biomechanics of our body. Lower limbs disorders are the source of great burden in healthcare, and is affecting a big share of the population, and longer because our lifetime is increasing. Anyway, one of the things that need to be managed is also because, paradoxically, the footwear is used to prevent and treat the problems. The prescription of insoles or shoes is being used, is the most common procedure to help treat the same problems that the footwear is creating. And it is surprising that even nowadays, the doctors and physicians still using their visual analysis, and also they are prescribing these kind of things without knowing exactly what is happening inside of the shoe for each particular patient. There are some technologies on place, but most of them are measuring the patient barefoot, so without providing any information about what is happening inside of the shoe. Or there are some in-shoe that are so complex and expensive, they are based on specialized labs and not addressed all the patients. So all these methods seems not to be helping doctors to prescribe well our footwear to improve our limbs disorders. This is the reason why we found an opportunity in designing walking sense, because this is the first in-shoe clinical device that is providing plantar pressure information, so the body weight distribution during walking, simultaneously with activity to be used to help doctors to prescribe well. And the intention, it is provide better treatment at a lower cost and reducing the number of visits to the doctor. He has also some applications that can be used in rehabilitation, for example, of a stroke patient or someone that suffered an injury, but can be used also to help set up and tune lower limb prosthetics from an amputee. Recently, we incorporate also video that can be gathered with any commercial camera or any mobile phone, providing to the ones that deal with athletes for the first time the information about the cause, so they can see the movement and knowing exactly what and synchronize what is happening inside of the shoe. Because our sensors last so they are so strong that they can be used inside of the shoe of an athlete during the practice of the sport. We are working already with football, rugby, and cricket, but we can see opportunities in all the almost all the sports where legs are used. In fact, we see a lot of similar things in taking care of these things for healthcare and for sports. Both act on affecting the posture to improve our condition. The device can be used also as an assistive technology because it's also providing feedback, for example, for the self-management of the condition of a post-stroke patient, providing feedback about their rehabilitation. And we truly believe that soon we will arrive with a device that can detect depression, because it's scientifically proven that all of us, when we are depressed, we change our posture and we change our walking pattern. So we are interested in measuring these kind of things. We have devices sold in almost all the places in the world, but we have been more active in Europe and recently in Australia, and we are looking for global partners that can join us and help us to market this amazing device worldwide. Thank you very much.
Questions? So, we've heard it behind the ear and we've heard it in the shoe. Should we combine the two?
Yes. True. It is true. But we are not only assessing posture. We are also assessing the plantar pressure. In fact, if you change the plantar pressure, you can influence your posture.
Other questions? And in terms of, this was a university spin-out, was it originally?
No, this is a product, it's a company.
It originated from within the company?
The origin, it was a device that was only to measure activity of lower limbs amputees, so it was not measuring plantar pressure.
Okay.
And we didn't find any uniqueness on that, and after we decided to incorporate plantar pressure sensors, so we could complement the information and provide unique information regarding a lot of things.
And are you able to translate the information to design orthotic devices better than is done at the moment by eye?
Yes. One of the things that we don't know is that plantar pressure is a little bit like fingerprints. You have your hand, I have my hand. And we are being prescribed with standard things that can be good for you but can be wrong for me. So this is providing quantitative and quantitative information to complement the visual analysis of the doctor and to help them to prescribe very easily adapt footwear for my condition and also for your condition.
Okay, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.